Hi, good afternoon, everyone. I really have to say I'm excited to introduce this bill. And I happen to be a former Navy chaplain, disabled vet. And I said last night, I was talking at the Providence Hebrew Day School, I said the mantra for a Navy chaplain is threefold. One, they bring you in to care for your own, fellow American Baptists. But the second reason they bring you in is to facilitate for others, the Jewish community, the Catholic community, the Muslim community. And the third thing that you do is you care for all. Provide for your own, facilitate for others, and care for all. And that's what we're doing this afternoon, showing care. Now, why am I excited about this bill? I'm excited for one major reason. This bill does not take a single dollar from public education. I want to make that clear. Does not take a single dollar from public education. It asks corporations, not big corporations, it could be any size corporation, to donate and take a tax credit. We served 415 students last year. That is less than 1% of the state's population. We had a person on the floor of the State House, one of my fellow reps, who spoke about gun violence in Providence. And they made the statement, and I don't disagree with it, that poverty plays a part in gun violence. I don't disagree with that. But you know what else plays a part? Is not having faith, not having morals, not having values. We know today, broken families, there's need out there. The thing that excites me about this bill, Catholic, Jewish, and Catholic schools, places that teach those very morals and values. And again, as an ordained American Baptist minister, as a former Navy chaplain, that is so important to me. And these children, I am so excited. And look at the cross section of children here, across the spectrum ethnically. And my wife and I, we do 3-4 events a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. We're involved in the minority communities. We understand a lot of the struggles. And we want to help and meet those needs. Our population, our Latino population is rising. And if you've been paying attention in the newspaper, you've seen articles about how our Latino children are underserved educationally. This leads to being underserved work-wise. Also, another article spoke about 15,000 underserved families in Rhode Island. We can do this. With your help, we can do this. So I'm asking for your help. Sign that petition. Reach out to your state legislator, your senators, your reps. Tell them, help pass this bill. Now people are also going to say, we can't afford it. We have a budget of $9.4 billion proposed this year. A state of 900,000 people. New Hampshire has a budget of only $5.7 billion. Maine, $7.1 billion. Delaware, $4.1 billion. In a $9.4 billion budget, we cannot find the money to raise this cap from $1.5 million to $5 million. I don't think that's necessarily the case. I don't think that's necessarily the case. If something's important enough, we can find the resources. And so I'm calling on the General Assembly, I'm calling on our state legislators, our leaders, to make this a priority. Our families are at risk. We need to step up and provide those opportunities. So again, I'm asking for your help, advocate. And my friends, it's also an election year. Let people know that this is important to you, that it matters. Who can be against helping families, providing for those in need? This is a great opportunity, and again, I make the point, it does not take a single dollar from public education. This is corporations providing money to go to scholarships. So let's raise that cap, let's advocate, let's get to the hearings, let's get into our communities and make that difference.